Hello, everyone. Welcome to Lighthearted Life and Collectibles. I have your nephew Kylo here, Kylo Jacoby. He's snoozing, as you can see. And look at him. He's got that little hand behind his head. He's just chillaxing in the badger basket. And what we're going to do, we're going to have a discussion topic. Are these babies our surrogate children? I got asked that today. So, I'm going to go get a diaper. I'm going to get his bottle, and we're going to talk about that as he gets a diaper change and a bottle feed.
What a wonderful world.
I got his bottle nice and warm right here, a little Playtex bottle. And we've got this little Huggies diaper that's got Winnie the Pooh. This is a size 2. You know, your nephew, he's been eating good. So we're going to see how this size 2 diaper fits him. But he's wearing this adorable little outfit from his Auntie Dottie. It is like a teal and orange. It has a little kitty cat on the chest, and the kitty cat's reaching for a star. I think it's so cute. And he has on his little booties. They say, I love you to the moon and back. And I have them on the wrong feet, so I'm going to have to change them out. Because here in America, we read from, we read from left to right and not right to left. So he was saying to the moon and back, I love you. And if we were Yoda from Star Wars, that would be fine. But anyway, we're just going to swap them around and put them the right way. So now they say, I love you to the moon and back. I love that they rattle. This baby boy is so sweet. I just love him to bitty bits. So, I'm going to try to change this where I don't have to edit and bleep anything out. But I don't know if I'm going to succeed or not. But anyways, I got asked the question today, because I was showing someone these babies who had never seen them before. And so, the way they asked me the question, it wasn't in a nice way. It was kind of in like a degrading kind of, let me try to insult you kind of way. But they said, so, what are these, like your surrogate children or something? And it was definitely oozing with sarcasm, this question. I started to say comment. It was not a comment on my channel. This was asked to me in person. And I was like, well, no, not for me. But, I mean, it could be for some people in the community. And if that's the case, then that's okay. Because what is it hurting? You know, I happen to know that there are people in the community who cannot have children, that would love to have children, that participate in this hobby. And if they wanted to use these beautiful, sweet babies as surrogate children, then what would it hurt? My opinion is absolutely nothing. Because this hobby does not hurt anyone. It doesn't hurt the person participating. It doesn't hurt other people. You know, so I don't think that is a big deal, even if somebody did use them as a surrogate child. But for me personally, because to me, you know, surrogate means like in the place of, you know, like you have a surrogate mom. So the surrogate mom carries the baby in the place of the actual mother of the child. She's not really the child's mother. She is just doing the job of carrying the baby because for whatever reason, the biological mother cannot. And that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing. That's actually a wonderful gift that someone can give. So if these babies can give the gift of being a surrogate child for someone who is childless, then I see nothing wrong with that. Because gifts are beautiful. There's nothing wrong with a gift. Everybody loves to get gifts, you know? So this is like, no matter how real the babies look, it's not going to be the same as having a real baby. I mean, I can give him this fake bottle of milk, and then I can go lay down and go to sleep and sleep all night long and go to work tomorrow and not take him to daycare because he's not a real baby. I can leave him right here in this badger basket, and he will be just fine when I get back home 8 hours later. You know what I mean? So even though they can fill a spot as far as, like, they help me with anxiety, I use these babies for therapy. They're also my hobby, but they're very therapeutic for me. And so, much like a weighted blanket, I love to hold them, cuddle them. You can feel their weight. Like, he weighs almost 10 pounds. So when you pick him up and you hold him, you can really feel his weight and then just how he moves. It's just wonderful. I love it. It's very therapeutic and it helps me a lot. So, yeah, I mean, I'll be the first to say that I use my babies for therapy. And I haven't had to take medication in a really long time because of that. And I'm not downing anyone who has to take medication. So don't think I'm saying, well, if you take medication, you're not hobbying right. Because, you know, there's no wrong way to hobby. You hobby and have fun. And if you still have to take medication, that's perfectly okay too. But I'm an empty nester. And yes, in a way, having these babies kind of lets me relive a moment, like holding a baby to give a baby a bottle or changing the diaper like I did just then. But it's on my time. It's not on the demand of the child because this is not a real child. So the things that I do with my dolls are for my entertainment. I can change his clothes whenever I feel like it. I can change his diaper whenever I feel like it. I can pretend to give him a bottle whenever I feel like it. It's not because he's screaming at 2 a.m. and needs a diaper change and a bottle. You know what I mean? Like, it's very different. So, even if I were to use the dolls as a surrogate child, because I'm an empty nester and my son is 28 and he's grown and married, and him and his wife, you know, they're doing wonderful. They have their own home, you know, and all that. So, I mean, like, even if I were to say, oh, because I'm an empty nester, I'm going to use these babies as surrogate children, it's still not the same as the full effect that you would get from having a real baby. Honestly, a real baby is too demanding for me at this point in my life to have on a daily basis. I'm not saying that I won't enjoy a grandbaby, you know, I'm not saying that at all. But as far as, like, my daily life every single day, I don't think I could handle taking care of a small baby. It would just be a lot. Like I said, they are very demanding, and you go on their schedule, not yours. So when you have a real baby, it's very different from having these, you know, fake babies that are lifelike. Because as lifelike as they can look, they just can't be lifelike as a real baby, and, you know, with everything that would go on. Now, there's an app called Babysit Me that could kind of give you the same effect, because you don't know when the app is going to go off and it's going to tell you what the baby needs and all that. And so, you know, it wakes you up all hours of the night if you want it to be that way. Like, you can have it for however many hours you want. As far as I know, I don't have the app, but I know some people that do, and they really like it because it will literally do, like, you could be in the middle of doing something else, just like in real life, and the Babysit Me app is going to go off. You might have just been fixing a bottle or going to go get a bottle or whatever, and then the baby's crying for some other reason. Just like in real life, you could be in the middle of fixing dinner, and then your baby needs something, and you have to stop what you're doing, see what your baby needs, and then when you get that need met, then something else goes on. The baby needs something else. You know, the ever famous, I just changed your diaper, but now you pooped. You know, that kind of thing. So, even though you can have fun with an app, that's still what it is fun, because whenever you get ready to turn that app off, guess what? You can turn it off and not use it. So it's still not the same as having an actual baby. Now, having said that, saying what I said before, reiterating on, you know, I know there are couples who can't have children and they are in this hobby and they enjoy the babies. These babies are like a good help for them. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. And there may be some that do treat them as a real child. Like, maybe they do the simulations where they have to get up in the middle of the night or whatever. And if that is what helps them, then that's okay. Because everybody deals with what life throws at them differently. And who are we to judge how someone deals with it? So, yeah, the way I was asked the question was very sarcastic in manner. It wasn't a curious question. It was a question that was more like a let me make you feel bad about your hobby kind of question. But little did they know, I've been there, done that, seen that, heard that. So there's not much people can say to me that I haven't already been told or been asked or that I don't have an answer for. Because I told this person, I was like, there's a whole community of us. You know, we share on Instagram. We have, some of us have YouTube channels. We get together in person. We have doll clubs and doll groups and all this. It's a whole community of people. So this is not like an isolated thing. It's worldwide. And that's what I told him. I was like, I have dolly friends all over the world. So this is not a little isolated thing. This is a wonderful hobby. And from the looks of it, it's here to stay. And surrogate child or not, I love this hobby. And to me, whether you are in this hobby just because you love to collect dolls, or you're in this hobby for therapeutic reasons, or you're in this hobby because you can't have children and so you get to enjoy that baby stage forever, no matter what the reason is, we all belong. There's not anything else I can say about that. We all belong here. We belong in this hobby. And we're not hurting ourselves. We're not hurting anyone else. So no matter if somebody is using the babies for a surrogate child or they're just in it for the hobby, let them have their peace. Let them have their peace, because everybody deserves peace. Let them have it. Let them have their peace. I didn't even give him this bottle, y'all. So I guess you're just going to see me put the bottle beside him then. Because by the time I said everything, I was like, oh, I didn't even like bottle feed him. So, but anyways, guess I could do it real quick here. We'll just give him this little bottle real quick. There we go. So that's it. Little Kylo is going to get his little bottle and we're going to have a good night. This is Wednesday night when I'm doing this video, but you're probably not going to see it until Thursday morning. So if you want to touch on this topic, let me know. And I would love to go to your channel and check out your view on it. If you would like to talk about using reborn and silicone babies as surrogate children, whether you do or not, or whatever your opinion is about it, then yeah, please let me know so I can go check out what you have to say. And Kylo says, I'm going to finish my bottle. See y'all in my next video. Bye. What a wonderful world.